Hello guys, welcome to the Web Epic channel. In this video, we'll be looking at how we can create an XML feed by using our plugin CTX Feed. So without further ado, let's get started and learn how we can do this. To create a new XML feed, you can go ahead and click on New Feed, or you can go to the sidebar and click on Make Feed. Once you've done that, you'll be prompted in this page to fill up the relevant details. For country, let's choose United States for this example. The template, I'll keep it as custom one. And let's name this XML1. Now the feed type is very important. Make sure under feed type, you choose the correct feed type. In this case, since you're trying to create an XML feed, we'll keep it at XML. The rest of the option, I'll keep them at their default values. The currency is at USD, which is correct. Let's look at the feed config now. Under feed config, we can see that our plugin has already pre-populated with some of the essential custom attributes. Now I'm happy with most of these attributes, so let's go ahead and move on. Under prices, I'll just put in a suffix of USD, so it looks a little bit better. Let's update and generate the feed, and let's take a look at what the file looks like. Now let's go ahead and download the file. There you go. This is what the XML feed looks like. As you can see, the suffix that we have added is showing up as expected. The brand is showing up as empty. So we'll make sure we change it in our product configuration feed so we can see some values here. So let's go back and add some attributes and make some changes to our feed configuration. So I'm going to go back here, click on XML1. And look at the custom attributes. Let's add a new attribute. I'm going to put in sale price and I'll select the correct value here, which is this, and I'll add a suffix of USD. If you want to rearrange the attributes, you can click on this icon right here and drag it and drop it. I'm going to keep it next to price so that I can easily compare the price and the sale price next to each other. Well, we saw in our feed that the brand was not pulling any value because I assume the brand is not configured correctly for all of our products. For now, I'm going to change this attribute to a pattern. When you choose pattern, it's going to return you with a static value. That means all the products will return the same value. So let's say all the brands are Nike. And I'm going to go ahead and update and generate the feed. Once the feed has been generated, let's download it and check if the changes we have made is showing. There you go guys, as expected, we can see under price the new attribute sale price is showing up, and under brand, since you've given it a static value, it's showing Nike. Let's look at a few other products. The brand is Nike, and as you can see in the other products as well, we can see the sale price. There you go guys. Now you know how you can create an XML product feed and edit it according to your needs. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webepic.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.